panel discussion of the day. We have some big names from the industry, as I mentioned a short while ago, who are going to be a part of this session. Our guests will be speaking about the rise of diversity in Bollywood. Well, without delay, first of all, I'd like to invite on stage Vandana Kataria, who started her professional career with Miditech in Delhi, after which she moved on to Bombay and started working as an assistant director to finally go on to direct TVCs herself. A big break came when she won a Filmfare Award for her work in Oi Lucky, Lucky Oi. She was also the production designer of the critically acclaimed film Shanghai. I request Vandana Kataria to thank you.
Now I'd request Pallavi Borua, member of the organizing committee of the Brahmaputra Valley Film Festival, to kindly felicitate Vandana Kataria, a small token of appreciation on behalf of the entire team of Brahmaputra Valley Film Festival. Thank you so much, Pallavi. Well, now please help me welcome Amrit Pritam on stage. Amrita was with us yesterday as well. Amrit Pritam is a national award-winning sound designer and is a graduate in physics from JB College, Jorhat in the year 1998. And he completed his sound engineering from the Regional Government Film and Television Institute of Guwahati in Assam in the year 2002. He has been working in Mumbai since 2002 and has more than 120 films to his credit in various languages like Hindi, English, Assamese, Malayalam, Tamil, Marathi and Telugu in various capacities as a sound designer, sound editor, sound mixer and a production mixer. He has also been the co-sound designer for films like PK, Kick, Highway, Ravan, and the list is a long one if I keep on telling about all the films. And he has also worked very closely with Russell Pokuti. We all know about that. Next, we all know that for any film to be successful, it needs to have a strong screenplay. Ritesh Shah, who is also known for his work in popular movies like Airlift, D-Day and Kahani, is a much sought-after screenwriter in Bollywood. Please help me welcome him with a huge round of applause. I'd request Pallavi Borua, member of the organizing committee of Brahmaputra Valley Film Festival, to felicitate Ritesh Shah, a small token of appreciation on behalf of the entire team of Brahmaputra Valley Film Festival. Next, I'd like to welcome on stage the filmmaker from Assam who made her directorial debut with critically acclaimed Honeymoon Travels Private Limited. Her neo-noir Talash was also a big success. Please put your hands together for Reema Kagti. I'd request Pallavi Borua, member of the organizing committee, to kindly felicitate our guest Reema Kagti. She's also closely associated with the Brahmaputra Valley Film Festival as an advisor and part of the jury for the short film contest. Thank you, Reema Kagti, for your support towards the festival. Now before we call on stage our moderator, I'd request the festival director to kindly come forward and share a few words with us.
Hi everyone, I just wanted to share something quickly about Reema. Reema has been a silent force behind this festival. Her genuine effort and time given to us is really inspiring. She wanted to put something together for her home region, and even though she has not been able to come for the last 2 years, but this amazing woman really deserves a big round of applause. So please, everyone, it'll be really nice. Thank you so much, Reema.
Well, thank you, Tanushree. Now we'd like to welcome on stage our final guest who will be moderating the discussion. He's none other than the award-winning journalist and senior anchor with CNN News 18, Karma Paljor. Please put your hands together. He was with us on day one as well, moderating the discussion with Prakash Jhaji, and he's here today as well. My microphone is also yours now.
Okay, I'm only used to handling one microphone. I got three. Thank you. Thank you so much. A little bit nervous because of the quality that I have in stage with me today. And I guess it is difficult because I was researching last night and I scribbled a lot of things. My handwriting is worse than a doctor's. So I've been scribbling a lot of things about, you know, the four of them, and my friends in the film fraternity said, how did you manage? What did you do to deserve to be in stage with the new stars of the film industry? So indeed, it's a great pleasure and an honor to be with you all here, talking about, I guess, a subject we all love. The topic today really is the rise of diversity in Bollywood. There are two ways to look at it. If we are to be looking at it from the prism of just the Northeast, many of us immediately go into the negative and maybe say, okay, the diversity of the Northeast truly has not been represented as much as it should have been in mainstream cinema. That's one way to look at it. But I always tend to stay with the positive. That's why I even had a show called India Positive, which didn't get enough sponsors in the end, so we had to pull it down. So, you know, people don't like anything that's positive. So if I look at it in the positive, I see great hope, because diversity is being represented. Movies are going beyond the cliches that they were based in, the same places. So that's the discussion today. And I will start with Amrit, because in the morning he said, ask me in the last. That's why I asked, start with you. You know, as a sound engineer, the movie highway, how many states you go through? And he was telling me, Karma, I will put a headphone, close your eyes, I'll be able to take you through about 7 states. And I will distinctly say, okay, this is Calcutta, this is Bombay, this is Guwahati, this is Gangtok, because every place has a distinct character. And he claims that he'll make me see sound, not hear sound. Very poetic. Would you elaborate?
Hello, everyone. So I'm not a good speaker, but anyway, fortunately and unfortunately. Fortunately, you can see cinematography, you can see editing, you can see acting, you know, and some extent even you can see music also, because you see a very good music or something like that. You know, you might be saying, oh, what a song or what a music, outstanding music or outstanding song or something like that. But when you watch a film, nobody, I never heard that somebody is saying that it's a very good song. Because I have been observing so many writing about critics. They give 4 stars, 5 stars, 3 stars, and they talk about the film, about acting, about cinematography, about editing, about background score, but they never talk about the sound. Then I realized, because since they can't see sound, so it's very difficult to write, you know. So see sound, and it's like, how can you see sound? It's all about like sound image, you know. So then how can we capture a sound image? So many things are happening around us, and we hardly concentrated on those particular things. Like if you go to Kolkata, so it has a different sound completely. It has a different identity. So the Kolkata has a different identity of sound. If you go to Bombay, it's completely different. And within Bombay, there are different sounds. Like till Bandra, you get different sound. If you move further, like from Bandra to Norman Point, so it's reflecting different kind of sound. If you go to Delhi, it's a completely different sound as compared to Calcutta and Bombay. And within Delhi, if you go to Jama Masjid or Chandini Chowk, it's completely different sound. So when he's just, you know, we are just talking about the diversity and all this stuff. So when a film shown any particular city or any particular area, so it is our responsibility to understand the entire place, whatever it's shown in the film, and then we have to go there, we have to identify different kind of sounds, you know, by our brain and along with a recorder, and we're just trying to represent with those particular sounds in the film. That means if a character is moving, or if a character, or if hero or heroine is talking on a street in Kolkata, so you should feel that you are in Kolkata. So when you're watching a film, just after 5 or 10 minutes, you don't know where you are. You never feel yourself that you are sitting in a theater and watching a film. By the time you feel that you are sitting on a chair and watching a film, that means, you know, your mind is detaching from the drama that is happening on the screen. That means when you're watching a film, you, after I think 4 or 5 minutes, you're suddenly gone inside the movie. You're gone inside the movie, and then you are a virtual character who is moving along in the film. Okay, if like, you know, any hero or heroine is walking or showing anything, so you yourself find within that imagination by imaginary area, you yourself moving around. Like if it's showing in London, you should feel that you are in London. If it's showing New York, you should feel you are in New York, you know. So to give that kind of impression, that means like, suppose I am just giving you, because you are from here, I just give you a few examples. Suppose if you go to the university, Guwahati University, if you are standing on the road, then you completely get a different sound image. What is sound image? So you'll get a different sound image in the sense like that students are going, walking, somebody is talking, somebody is coming by car, somebody is coming by bike. So it's completely different scenario there in front of that university. So that when we're showing a university, then you should feel that you are going inside a university, or if a class is going on, you should feel that you are one of the imaginary character sitting within the class, even if it's showing the film, you know. So likewise, if you go to Chandmari area, like I'm talking about, like, you know, if you go to in front of commerce in the evening, so it's a completely different sound. It's a completely different image, because all the correct, most of the time, all guys are coming out, you know, small groups, and they're going addas at the Chandmari or at commerce. But in the morning, it's also different. And even during the day, it's also different. So within the time, the sound changes everywhere. It's not about like in front of commerce or in front of university or in front of anywhere. So sound changes with time. So it's an interesting thing. So that when we were doing a film, so if it's a morning, if it's a day, or if it's an evening, or if it's a midnight, so we have to change the sound. So when we are talking about diversity, I'm just talking about the film Imtiaz Ali's Highway. Fortunately, we have done the sound design myself. So we decided to do the film, especially the sound design, with only the ambient sounds, which is very rare in case of Bollywood. Like Bollywood, more into music and songs and dialogues and foreground music. There is no, I think, very little film has background scores, but most have foreground scores. So in Imtiaz Ali's Highway, we decided to do that. We have to do the sound design with specific ambience. So how we can create specific ambience? Because the film is shown, it started to Delhi, then it moves to Gujarat, then it moves to Himachal, then it moves to like Punjab, then Himachal, then Kashmir. So it's like Delhi, Gujarat, Punjab, Himachal, then Kashmir. So that means we have to create the sound in such a way so that when the character is moving from one state to another, so that audience should also feel themselves that they are moving along with the character shown in the film. So they have to also move from Delhi to Gujarat to Punjab, then Himachal and Kashmir. So if you watch the film, then you realize how we design the sound in there. Like in Delhi, it's completely, we design the sound from Delhi point of view. Once it goes to Gujarat, so you can see like a huge area, the desert area. So hardly you can see anything there. Like it's not a desert, but like I think it's a big area. I forgot the name, Kutch or something like that. So there, we create the ambience with different kind of air sound, different kind of air in the sense like I'm talking about winds. Because winds changes, winds always fluctuate, like rain always changes. So that means if you watching a film, if there is a wind shown or if there is a wind there, so you just can't lay wind track there. So that wind has to move, you know, like the way that music has, you know, crescendo, and then it's gone down, then again it's going up. So wind also should move like that. So in that particular area, we create the entire ambience, entire atmosphere in different kind of winds and a single bird. That one single bird representing the mindset of the girl. If you watch the film again, then you can realize that things. And then again, once it will go to Punjab, so you can hear the ambience of Punjab, like, you know, that Gurudwara's prayer is coming out. So that Gurudwara's prayer and then other elements can represent that those characters are somewhere hiding in Punjab. So likewise, when they goes to Himachal and then they are like, you know, moving around in Himachal, you know, like, you know, in Dharamsala, it's mostly, you know, Dalai Lama's place, and then so many monasteries are there, Buddhist monasteries are there. And then if you've been to Dharamsala, then you realize in every corner you can hear that Stupa Pear Hill. There's a huge bell, it's called Stupa Pear Hill. So you have to, it's moving like this, and it has a sound, and it has a different kind of vibration. Number one is that. Number two is that, the Buddhist chanting, it has a different chanting in the morning, in the evening, during the day. So it has a different, they produce different kind of peculiar kind of modulations, basically with low frequency, like kind of things. So when they gone to those places, so we use those kind of sounds, like especially Stupa Pear Hill, and then Buddhist chanting that coming from the long distance. You know, and apart from that, you can have a different kind of particular mountain bird in Himachal. It's not only Himachal, any mountain area you go, then you can find a specific 2-3 birds where only, you know, they are available there. And especially the crow sound, you don't know that, I think you the crow sound always changes, you know. The crow sound that we have here in Guwahati or in Bombay is completely sounding different. In Himachal, it's like caw. It is like that.
Because that's a Himachali.
Yeah, it's maybe Himachali crow. Yeah. So when you do sound, so we just can't put a crow. Suppose a crow is there showing their crow, crow, crow. So we just can't put the crow. You know, we have to identify him like from which place it is. It's maybe, you know, in Himachal is sounding completely different, or in a hills area. So like using different kind of crow sound and small different kind of birds. And Stupa Prayer Hills, and then Buddhist chanting, and all combined together, we're creating that Himachal ambience. Then it's gone up to the Kashmir. So again, there also we're creating a different mountain ambience, which is related to Kashmir. So that the film shows 6 or 7 states, and then we are very fortunate that we are born and grown up in India, that within 100 kilometers, we move on, we'll get a different culture. And different atmosphere and different ambience. So if you see that film, so this is how we create it from one stage to another. So when you talk about Bollywood, so Bollywood films are not restricted within Bollywood now. So it's gone far beyond. It's gone far, far beyond. So they are using different subjects from different states. They're making films like Mary Combs from Manipur. You know, so Maricom was made on the basis of Maricom. I think the shoot was done, half of the shoot was done in Manipur and half of the shoot was done in Himachal. Anyway, so it's gone beyond Bollywood. So there are new subjects are coming up, which is you can't see earlier, those kind of things. Like, you know, Milkha Singh, one of the my best favorite film, and then I think Farhan Akhtar's one of the best.
So what you're saying is, yeah, there is diversity, and diversity is coming. I also get it, because if you go to a house, you know, there are different sounds during the day. That's what I learned from today, and I'm going to take it back. Husband and wife are there with kids, there'll be different sound. When only husband and wife are there in the house, there'll be different sound.
Correct.
After 11 o'clock in the bedroom, there'll be different sound. So do you really record those sounds and go at 11 o'clock into somebody's house and record those sounds? Or do you create it digitally? I've learned a lot.
See, during the morning, during the day, during the evening, during the dinner time, it's easy to record sound in anywhere, in any places with request. But after 11, I don't know.
Might get beaten up. We journalists get beaten up all the time. Sound award-winning sound artists getting beaten up, it'll be new. So with that, I come to you.
Thank you.
Embarrassing questions. He talked about Maricom. An issue that's been debated, I think it's been done, you know. I mean, every time that Maricom issue comes up, I cringe. I say, it's just a movie. She's done a good job. Now, we need to move on. But Reema, do you really see that diversity that we are talking about happening across the country? And what does diversity mean to you? And how would you like to, you know, present it in your movies?
Okay, so in terms of, you know, you've asked me several questions, so I'll deal with the Maricom one. I think that on some level, yes, it's great that mainstream Bollywood. See, I'd like to make a distinction here, because independent films, smaller films, there a diversity does exist. But the bigger the budgets get, that's the problem. That's when things start getting more and more homogenized. And also, there is a thought that in terms of, you know, it's entertainment. People don't want to deal with serious issues. I don't want to see the struggles of a Kashmiri. I don't want to see how a Manipuri is getting troubled by the army. I want to see happy things. I want to see fluffy things. So again, there, you know, I think that yet at the same time, movies are, film is an art form. And it is the job of filmmakers, like other artists, to hold up mirrors to society. So there's a balancing act that I think a scriptwriter or a director has to do, where, you know, on one hand, you're trying to play to the galleys almost. On the other hand, you're trying to take on some of the social responsibility that I'm sure most of us feel as writers or directors. So in that sense, Maricom happening in mainstream Bollywood is very exciting, though, you know, people are upset. I think that Maricom was played by Priyanka Chopra, who is a Punjabi, and of course, you know, there's a problem with that inherently. Having said that, I think the decision was taken by the producers because that was the only way the film would recover its money. So though there is an attempt, on one hand, to be diverse, to pick up a story of a woman in Manipur who could potentially inspire the whole nation, and that is somehow trying to be balanced with the fact that film is a very, very expensive art form, you know? So I think that in this need to balance things out, most of the time the casualty is diversity, you know? Like he mentioned, there have been several other films which really do make an attempt, like Bhag Milka Bhag or Heather. These are films that are talking about uncomfortable subjects. They're talking about, you know, stuff that would not be considered pure entertainment. But at the same time, they're making an effort to move out of what normally our commercial films are, you know. So I think at this point in history, it's the effort and the fact that it's there, it's the most that it's ever been. But is that good enough? Probably not.
So I was in Punjab, you know, studying the farm suicides and all these issues and all. One day I had a free time. So I watched a movie, local channel in Bathinda. The movie was called Jatt James Bond. You all should watch it. It's a brilliant movie. Next time I'm going to write to the director. Maybe, you know, a part two, I can be the Jatt James Bond. I think it should be cool. Okay, part three. If true diversity is, then maybe I'll be accepted by the audiences. But Ritesh, is there pressure when you're writing, you know, to write a scenario, to build an environment which is appealing to a larger audience? Chennai Express worked a lot. I like the movie. Is there an attempt to reach out and, you know, to as many people as possible? The point that she alluded to, that maybe, you know, you cannot take just one little section and make a movie on it, which will not be appealing to the rest of the country.
Very comprehensive question, so I might take some time. See, in an ideal business situation, actually, an industry which is commerce-driven should have aimed for the biggest market, right? So essentially, films should have been diverse. I mean, they should have included characters from all parts of the country. And wherever we have distribution, as in we have divided the country into 13 distribution regions, out of which now suddenly the Northeast and Kerala and Tamil Nadu, which are one territory, and even the East for that matter, which we call Odisha, they are not very lucrative territories. They don't make much money for Bollywood. So, consequently, there is no appeal to do well in those centers. In terms of stories, for a long time, they did business in only three or four major centers. So, till the mid-90s, there was almost no geography also. They would not identify even cities. And they were restricted to three surnames. If you closely look at films till 80s, you'll have three surnames. Two of them would be Punjabi neutral without identifying the caste. And one would be a pan North Indian Gupta friend. The others would be Khanna or Arora, or there were two or three more variations. A Sharma would replace a Gupta sometimes. As the market grew slightly, they needed fodder. As in, forget about the Northeast, most of the film actors and directors were from Northeast Bombay. They didn't include Northeast Maharashtra also. So to find somebody else was literally out of the question. Reema was talking about Marycom, and she said Priyanka Chopra, who's a Punjabi, played Marycom. Thankfully, some of the
Sikkimis will play Punjabi. Sardar.
So some of the...
Just imagine my face with a turban and a little beard. Jatt James Bond. I don't know. Yeah, actually, yeah. It's racist, but yeah. It's true. They are. They are. Yeah.
Now legally, she's in for 5 years. the other extreme was, she mentioned one more film, Haider. Barring the two cops, which are played by Lalit Parimu and Amir Bashir, everybody who was there in the film was not Kashmiri. So there are two ways of looking at it. See, I would say glass half empty and half full, but this is not even half. We are talking about 5% or 5 ml or 10 ml. Within that, thankfully, I think since 2004-2005 maybe, a lot of technicians and storytellers have come in from different centers, smaller centers. For example, we go to the other extreme of the country. I am from the north, I am from South Kashmir, Anantnag. You could not have had a Hindi film scriptwriter from a region which can't pronounce basic Hindi words properly. Mm. Like the first time I came to Delhi for Kaun, which is who, I used to say Kone. And my Hindi teacher said, Kaun will be found in Kataria sir's maths class. This is Kaun. So for somebody from that part to come and eventually write Hindi films, and of course I learned the language better. I could write it well, but I couldn't, speak well. Therefore, I couldn't narrate. But I learned, and now... So Like this year in January, we did a story about Indians in Kuwait, and largely Indians in Kuwait were Goans, Malayalis, Punjabis. Things have drastically changed in the last two and a half years. I think we'll have more stories. For example, in September, Ronnie Lahiri, who's I think one of the mentors of the festival, is producing a film called Pink. Which not only has an actor from the Northeast, I mean, it features Andrea Tarang, who's from Shillong. So she's a songwriter, singer, actor from there. She not only is part of the film as an actor, but as somebody who plays a Northeast girl living in Delhi. Now that's a Delhi story. So suddenly there's a Lucknow girl, there's a girl from Shillong, and there's a local Delhi girl. So as these stories enter mainstream cinema, I mean, it stars Amitabh Bachchan, so you can't get more mainstream than that. Now, as these stories start entering Bollywood, I think more and more people, not just from Northeast, but even from states which are underrepresented. For example, Odisha has given us the best art directors and musicians, but, you know, even though they have a slightly functional film industry, they have never given talent, and that's a very artistically inclined state, but not represented that much. And there are a lot of other states in India which really love the arts, but haven't, I mean, the representation of other states, even in terms of main stories, would be less than 10%, including the glorified Punjab. There are no real Punjabi stories. Like a 1984, the film that's made in Punjabi, it's not made in Hindi. There was one Marches which was in God knows when I was a kid, I guess. So, but as these storytellers are finding space out of their own struggles in Bollywood, their stories will also find space. And possibly with the growth of cinema, like I certainly notice multiplexes here. So I think as the markets also expand in these non-Hindi centers, I think they'll find more representation.
And Vandana, we can see the change, isn't it? Like, you know, what you guys did with Detective Bomkesh, you know, first period, brilliantly done set. You went on a discovery yourself. You took about, what, 2 years to really put everything together. So you do see diversity now. I won't say massively, but creeping in a good amount.
Yes, and I mean, I can't really react to this as a production designer, but just as a filmmaker, you know, and I have to say I second his thought and because those stories are coming in. There is representation of people, technicians, writers, even directors slowly, who are coming from these parts of the world, you know. And I think what probably hinders us a little bit is the star-driven system still. Like, we are still in the 70s star-driven filmmaking. I mean, the studio tried to come in, couldn't do anything. The corporate came in. It's still star-driven. So I think either we create stars big enough in other pockets as well, or as audiences, which we are kind of, and makers, be able to understand the, you know, like stories which are really true and deep in their context, touch you nevertheless. Like, we consume foreign cinema, na? There's a Mexicano film, a Spanish film, an African film, and you believe it completely because the suspension of disbelief is so beautifully done that I become a Spanish person without knowing history. So if I get engrossed in the film, I may go back and read up a little to understand the context, but I believe it. I never question it. I think that's also because of the conviction that those films are made with. We are doing that now, but we can probably find a lot of these smaller stories from all over India, make them with a truth. And I think the star system actually hinders us big time, because I know a dear friend who's actually working on a Northeastern story set right here, Northeastern characters written by somebody right here. I know somebody who's doing a Malayali thing like that. But I know both such people will get tempted to cast the big star because it's a commerce-driven industry. Filmmaking is an expensive art form. And if the film's going to cost money to make, you got to back it with that star, because that's the only way, as a director, as a producer, you want to make your next film. That's the incentive. So you want to make money. at least make back money to make that. So I think we're caught in a bit of a catch-22 there. But and I can't answer this as a PD because PD does everything. So you tell me to go to Antarctica, I will research it, find everything about it, and set us set right here, and it'll be Antarctica. So
no, in a sense.
I think what Vandana can't say about herself, which I can because we have worked closely, is a lot of the times the diversity that you see in a film, you know, it doesn't necessarily have to be a breakaway topic or like something about insurgency or something like that. It could just be that a person who's, say, for example, Bengali should feel, look, the house should be of a Bengali person. Now that these kind of things really depend on the director and the crew, how hard they work, how much they research, and how real they want to get. Because as and when you get more and more real, you will get more and more diverse. And so what Vandana won't say about herself and why Bomkesh looks the way it did is because it's based on extensive research and based on trying to get it right. You don't know, just want it to be vaguely, you know, look like it was a period film.
Yeah, I mean, my trip was to please every historian in this country, if there are any, that they can't catch a mistake. I mean, I did Bomkesh with that intent.
Were there any good-looking ones?
No, historians are usually 90 years old and they don't look good anymore.
I don't agree. So, you know, like, a movie is a living organism, right? Till the time it gets released, then the stars take over completely. In that context, because we have the heart, that's you guys, from every state, every little part of the country, just like I have to fight within my editorial to get stories from the south, from the east in sometimes, you know. When you have an idea, how difficult is it to influence a star
who loves your work, just to nudge him and say, introduce this tiny little element, like what happened to that Three Idiots, that movie, you know, the Wang Du could have been, you know, somebody else. He could have been from Odisha, and there are lovely schools in Odisha, there are lovely locales in Odisha, you know, he could have come from Kerala, anywhere. Is there a nudge required sometimes? Because after that, tourism in Ladakh has changed. There are Karishma scooters everywhere. You go to Pangong Lake, you see three Karishma scooters, and all the tourist guides will swear that that is the scooter that Karishma Kapoor sat in.
Pangong's become dirty because of Three Idiots.
Okay. That's another issue, another topic, and we can take it up.
So now some secrets have to be spilled. Actually, star love lasts Fridays, depending upon how convincing you have been the last Friday. It's very, very difficult to push stars to do anything. Forget about comfort zone, to do anything. I actually went to a star this summer and said, why don't you do films? And he said, I don't have the confidence to be a failure. So it's better to do a lot of ads and not to decide on any film. So it becomes very difficult to push them to do anything. It becomes difficult to push studios to do anything. It becomes difficult to push directors to do anything, because most of the time they're pushing for things themselves. This whole representation thing is that you do get people interested. It might be a song, it might be a musician, it might be an actor, it might be a character from somewhere outside. But once you bring him into the mainstream, there's such collective fear, as in we are very scared people in Bombay, and within just three pin codes, like Andheri, Juhu, Bandra, it doesn't transcend Bombay. That's why I say when we talk about the Northeast or Kashmir, that's far, far away. It doesn't transcend three pin codes of Bombay. So you might get somebody like, say, Prithviraj from Kerala. And Prithviraj has done one film in which he was stereotyped as somebody who's good looking and from Kerala and therefore exotica in one film. In another film, he's a guy from Gurgaon and he's the narrator of the film. And he's not a Malayali cop from Gurgaon, he's a Haryanvi cop from Gurgaon. So even if you get talent from outside, they have to kind of, you know, fill into a North Indian, Hindi speaking And by now I have forgotten the question. What was it called? Yeah, is there pressure or can you pressurize into
experiment? You said no, difficult.
Difficult, but as I said, you know, I always start, as you said, that, you know, there are two ways of looking at it. First, you start with a rant, that's okay, it's pretty bad. So once we are exhausted with that, yes, there are possibilities opening up. We will be able to get more and more talent from other states, including the Northeast. And Reema said something which I'm just catching on to. She said it could be a very normal thing. It doesn't have to be diversity in your face. So last 20 years, they have done a lot of young films. Three friends, four friends, six friends, seven friends.
In 20 years, they couldn't find a Kashmiri friend or a friend from the Northeast. So at least in one film, we have started with one friend from the Northeast. It's not innocuous, it's not in your face. Her corner of the room hasn't been done by the art director very differently. There might be touches, but it's not obviously Northeast. She's not wearing traditional costumes. I think by about the middle of the film, we'll forget where she is from and should be just a girl among the three. Of course, there are issues touched upon slightly which deal with the perception of how people in Delhi deal normally on a day-to-day basis with a woman and then a Northeastern woman. So that gradient will also be reflected in the film. But I suppose we would start with things like that. That could I do, hey, there's an interesting dentist character in the film. Could he be from the Northeast? Could he be from the South? It doesn't hamper your market. It doesn't destroy your territories. He's not your lead. The director would obviously ask you, why is it required for the story? It may be required, it may not be required. You could just say it's my quirk, or just let's do something different. Inertly, yes, it would be some sort of a responsibility to get somebody from somewhere else. I think we should start small and then kind of move big.
And Amrit, finally, when you walk the red carpet at the Oscars, yeah, 2000, I don't know when you do, how will you change it? What will you bring?
No, I never walked for Oscars. It was Russell who went to the Oscars for...
When you...
Oh, me? Oh. No, I'm not dreaming about Oscars. We never walk thinking about awards or something like that. Yeah, like, you know, we just to walk for the film. And our principles, I don't know about others, like when we walk in any films, we don't walk for the directors, we walk for the film. This is our principles. So when a film comes to us, we always concentrate about the film only and how we can lift the film to another level, only help of sound and its quality. And never dreaming about awards. I don't know. I can't answer about this.
Okay, don't dream, they'll come. Reema, how would you do it differently? You're already working very closely with two stars. You worked with Farhan and Zoya. Looking at them, and you are already at a leadership role. How would you do things differently to bring in more diversity? Do you have a plan, or have you never thought about it? You've just gone with the flow.
Well, I do have a plan, but I mean, I think it's like Ritesh said, you have to do it in small ways. You know, you can't, if I decide to be, you know, sort of in some way fashion myself as the representative of the Northeast, who's only going to make Northeast subjects and cast Northeast people, I might be out of a job in Bombay. Like he said, we're very scared people. So these things scare us very easily. But I think that if I could get over some of my fears and just approach things in a very small way. There is a lot of misrepresentation. So there is a misrepresentation of the diversity. There's a misrepresentation of women. There's a misrepresentation of, I think, really your culture on a level. So the only way is, like he's saying, in small ways where filmmakers, scriptwriters, producers, everybody becomes a little bit more conscious. And I think in as it is, as our films are getting slightly, you know, like he was saying, in the 90s, our films were not layered. And they were just these generic films, either it's a love story or it's a thriller or it's some kind of revenge drama, and all of them had pretty much the same thing going on. But there is a pressure on a filmmaker, a scriptwriter, to do something better than that now. That is dated, it's not going to work anymore. So automatically when this pressure has come on you to produce better work, in terms of film, I mean, the more you can recreate reality, the better it is. And I think if you do that truly, the diversity or the misrepresentation will take care of itself.
Right. And the truth is really, you know, if a movie has a great story, some great characters are built, Vandana, the story runs. Like you said, I watch a lot of Spanish movies. I watch a lot of Iranian movies, you know, out of the net. I got some 1,000 movies and I'm left with some 400 to go. And there is joy. You find joy. You're happy. But to each his own. You know, the same formula does not work for everybody. So like you rightly said, you know, cutting through that diversity, making a movie diverse is not showing a Naga friend wearing the traditional gear and with a spear and standing by me all the time. I guess that'll be wrong. And do we then are at a loss for proper research when we go and do movies? Do mainstream movies lack research? Therefore, they're not able to, you know, touch the heart.
I think that research is, but lacking at the producer script writing when they're initiating the, because any production designer and art director, if a director comes and gives you the script and it is set in Tamil Nadu, then it's any production designer business to go figure Tamil Nadu out. But if the producer and the director and the writer are not writing a film set in Tamil Nadu, then I surely can't put it in there when it's supposed to be in Punjab. You know, but I think it's happening. I mean, I'm doing a tiny little story. My protag's best friend is a Manipuri boy. And, you know, there's a key Bihari character. And so it is happening, I agree. But small films, I don't have a star in there. So Okay. It's possible.
I think louder. They could hear the Manipuri boy. The main protagonist's best friend is a Manipuri boy. Do you want to give slightly more away? Like you said, Ritesh, that Bombay is limited to 3 pin codes. So was Kathmandu. You know, at one time, Nepali films did well, a lot of market. They still do. But again, the stories, everything was limited to just around Kathmandu. A friend of mine sent me 2 movies from Kathmandu, and I was just taken aback. Those 2 movies were set in Mustang. Mustang around the Himalayas is most beautiful area, you know, unexplored, I would say. And both the movies are set there and very, very powerful. So again, the same thing, that you don't need the stars, you don't need, you know, the gimmicks or something. But what you need is the heart of the movie, which is the great story and the characters.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. If it's happening in Nepali...
No, I just watched 2 movies, so maybe it is.
It's a small number, but for an industry which doesn't produce a lot of films, it's fine. You mentioned Phunsuk Wanglu. Ladakh actually has a functioning film industry. I mean, it's video-based, but they have their own. It's a significant industry. And with Bollywood, I mean, we'll use the phrase Bollywood. See, it's not just who is coming inside, who's getting into the industry. It's also who is consuming. So this reflection is not just who has come inside. It's also a reflection of who's coming into the multiplex or the single theater. Now, the bigger centers are always Bombay, Delhi, Calcutta, Mysore, Hyderabad, these 5 states, these 5 centers. And they are themselves getting a diverse audience. Like, I can give you an example. I remember Heram, I think it was around 15 years back. It released around 15 years back. The protagonist's wife was Bengali. And she used to speak some lines in Bengali. And this is a suburban theater in Bombay. People used to laugh whenever she would speak in Bengali or she would use a Bengali word. This has completely changed. If you move from Heram to Chennai Express, even the consumer is okay. That if there's somebody who's Tamil, he can speak Tamil or it could be accented. There is still a lot of stereotyping, but it depends on the sensibility of the person. So as I said, the change doesn't come just from within who has entered Bollywood. It also comes from who who is buying the ticket. I think those ticket changers are also responsible for a lot of the stories changing. Probably they're reading more books. Some of the books have come from Northeast and other parts. They are open to stories or characters from other parts. They're also exposed to a lot of other people from India, and therefore they would be open to characters from there. For example, a lot of people who go to Delhi University would be much more familiar with the Northeast than anybody, because, you know, even if you're living in a hostel, I mean, 20% of the people would be from the Northeast. So compared to any other guy in the country for whom a person from the Northeast is a generic Nepali or whatever, large number of Delhi University boys would know whether the person is Sikkimese or Naga or Manipuri based on, you know, certain things that they come with their experience. So one, I feel the audience itself will change the stories. The more people we have, say, from Northeast who are unrelated to the film industries, coming to live in more and more cities, working different jobs, they'll also change the stories. They'll influence them indirectly. They're not within Bollywood, but they're outside. And people would also turn, look left and right. They would see people, their doctor could be from Sikkim. So then they would accept characters like that.
Right. And to talk about diversity, just look at the new dimension that's been created by social networking. Kabali, Rajnikanth. I mean, immense. I've got on my Facebook timeline, I've got, Jat friends from Noida going and watching Kabali and writing funny comments there, you know. So it's also a lot to do now with social networking that drive this. Otherwise, would you have seen this kind of a craze across? I was watching one of the Assamese news channels. They were playing a full story on Kabali. Would you have seen this kind of thing? Had the social networking thing not been there, has it added a new dimension? Will it influence the three pin codes more than it has before?
Social network has had a huge impact on how films are marketed and how it comes to an audience. But for the three pin codes, you know, to get influenced, I think the important thing, like he was saying, is, you know, in forums like this, when we talk about film and we talk about the responsibility, it's always put on filmmakers. And like he's saying, it doesn't end with us. You know, it has to reach out to the audience. And, you know, what I was trying to tell you earlier, I think more and more now, people are not wanting to see film. You know, their trip is entertainment. If I want to get some information or I want to learn about something, I'll watch a documentary, because there are really good documentaries out there which are available to me, which, say, even 10 years ago was not so accessible to a person. So whereas I think this whole web culture has opened things out, on a level it's also put extreme pressure on filmmakers. Because A, you've got some serious competition from documentaries to be like the real stuff. That's one. Secondly, I think, you know, to say Bollywood is still in a better place than where Hollywood is. It's primarily big budget, high concept, franchisee films that get made, or very small films. You know, you're just, they are in fact losing their diversity in a very big way in film. And a lot of it is because of web content. So in that sense, we are at a better place. We can do much better. And we should do much better, because we are such a diverse country that our popular entertainment should reflect that. So, in no ways am I saying it's perfect, but I think we're in a far better place than a lot of other countries. And on some level, that's coming from a small section of the audience supporting them, and a small section of, like he's saying, people who come into Bombay, upcoming writers, filmmakers, who it's in their genetic makeup. It's what they are. They're not trying to do it out of making an effort or, you know. So it has to come organically. And it has to come from audiences and filmmakers alike. Because just one, you know, just the audience clamoring to see something and filmmakers not doing that, or filmmakers have decided these are the kind of films you should watch. And you know, which I think on a level is, because in spite of forums like this and all the, you know, conversation about social responsibility and this and that, at the end of the day, every year, if you look at the type five most, you know, the five big blockbusters, they are just pure, or, you know, the kind of pure entertainment value, and they have absolutely nothing else to them.
Right. So to break it down simply, if you love March Bath, you'll always love March Bath. You go to New York, you want March Bath. You go to Iceland, you want March Bath. So that's the audience for you. With that, let's open it up for questions. Please identify yourself and ask your question. Don't limit yourself to diversity. You can ask any question, because I don't think we are going to get these people like this talking to you ever. I don't know. In my lifetime, I don't think so. Unless I throw a very lavish party somewhere and pay airfare and all to get them down, which I can't afford as a journalist. There. Any question, don't limit yourself to diversity. Personal questions, not welcome.
Okay, I have a question for Reema, and, you know, generally for everybody. We keep hearing this over.
Can we have your name?
Yes, sorry. My name is Rupa Barua.
Thank you.
And my question is, we keep hearing this, and I'm from Assam myself. You know, I live in Mumbai. And we keep hearing this over and over again, that Assam is not represented, and, you know, whatever, the Northeast is not represented. Could we take the onus on ourselves and try to show ourselves to the rest of the world, instead of saying, you know, why is Bollywood never, you know, showing us as, you know, agreed, we are all niche, as you just said, you know, it's only those few characters that are shown over and over again. And could you, and I know you are from here too, so maybe you and, you know, I'm, everybody else, you know, I just, that was my thing. Do we, should we put the onus on ourselves and take ourselves out to the world versus saying that, you know, why can't they show us?
But we do have, no? Jorhat Boy and Guwahati Girl.
No,
I understand the question in the way that you mean it. Should, yes and no, you know. I think that things have to happen more organically. Because even if all of us decide to, you know, take it on as a personal crusade, I don't think you're going to really end up achieving much. So it has to happen much more organically. And I mean, they're two separate, I think in what you asked me, they're two separate things. The Hindi film industry is one thing, and the Assamese film industry is another thing. Now, in terms of the Assamese film industry, you know, in spite of a very glorious past, I think things have really, you know, come to a standstill. And what makes me happy is a lot, you know, I see a lot of young filmmakers and people kind of getting up. And even though, because you're an Assamese film, you have a very small budget, that is not hindering them, and they're getting up and making and doing some really good work. Like today at 5 o'clock, there's a film that I'm really looking forward to seeing, because it's basically exactly the kind of thing I'm talking about. So yes, you can take the onus on yourself in this kind of way. But again, when you're talking about bigger and bigger budgets, it becomes, you know, you've got to figure it out.
Right. I'm not saying as much as a social responsibility. I'm just saying, like, you know, unique stories that need to be told. I mean, I'm, you know, I'm not speaking in terms of responsibility to, you know, show my world. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Hello, I'm Shobhik Bhattacharya. When you talk about diversity in Bollywood, the one name that comes to my mind is Denny Danzongpa. So someone like Denny Danzongpa, he has played all sort of characters. So I never, like, I'm not concerned whether someone is, like, he played the role of a North, whether he plays the role of a North Indian or like a Punjabi or whatever. So the thing is, like, if a person, if he has the quality, if he has the quality, people will sign him. People will sign him for any sort of role. I will never question whether if he wears a turban, and he has played the role of Thakus and whatnot. So if you have the quality, you can sustain yourself in the Bollywood. So what is the fuzz about? There's recently I've heard that Leonardo Caprio is being signed to play the role of Jalaluddin Rumi. So he's the best man for the job, in my eyes. So what is the fuzz about?
No, I agree with you. And I hope that more and more young wannabe actors from places where they feel, they, if they come to mainstream industry, they'll get boxed or put in a, you know, kind of thing. I hope they're listening to this. And Danny, I think, is actually an inspiration. And the sad thing is that there aren't so many Dannys today. That's the sad thing. So I think you've brought up a really good point.
So I used to be a mountain guide also. And once I had a group of German tourists who had come to Sikkim. And I had taken them around before the trek started. I'd take them around Yuksam. And I was young. So I had to take them to the old coronation stone of the king of Sikkim to show them. By mistake, I took them to Danny's house. Danny was not there. Only his caretakers are there. So he saw a lot of Gora. And he thought that, you know, maybe they are Danny's guests. And they made us all sit in the sitting room and took us to the main altar. And the German guide started telling them about the king of Sikkim and all. And I tell them, sorry, oops, you know, I'm at the wrong place. Danny's house.
No, you can carry on if you want. To be very honest, Bollywood is not a central government organization. It's not run under Ministry of Cultural Affairs. Or it's not. Okay. And Bollywood is not belongs to any community. Okay, it belongs to India. And Bollywood is completely different ballgame. So it is not run under by any human resource or Ministry of Information or Cultural Affairs or something like that. So they can't instruct anyone to make a film and keep an Assamese hero into it. Okay. So our problem is that we always restrict ourselves within our own community and we don't go out and don't learn from others. So as far as we restrict ourselves within this limit, then we always have a question of this kind of things. Why would Bollywood come and make a film on us? Or why would Bollywood make a film and keep an Assamese hero or a Manipuri hero or something like that? It's completely different. See, Bollywood is like, it's money-making, filmmaking industry. So it's not independent or parallel or something like that, you know. See, it doesn't make those kind of films. So when you talk about this kind of diversity or if you want this kind of film, where if the story is based in Assam or you need an Assamese actor, so you can probably find it in, you know, in independent film or which we call as like a films mix for festivals. But when it comes to Bollywood, if Subhasgai is making a film, so why would he keep an Assamese hero into it? Because he's going to spend some 15 to 100 crores and he's going to get back some 5-6 lakhs out of it. So there is no question of making a film in such a way. So we should keep in mind that this is not a government organization. So it's not going to give some reservation for Assamese or Manipuris or these things. I am from Jorhat. I studied in Assamese medium school. I can't even speak properly Hindi and English. But I went there. I survived 1 year without working anything. But somehow, you know, I is still here. I have been working with Rasul. So you already mentioned about Danny also. So look-wise is also different. We are different than others. You know, our look is different. So like it cannot be acceptable in any cases. I think we should think beyond about Bollywood, because they are not our guardian. And then, you know, like, are yaar, mere ko ek chance de do, kaam kar Assam se aao. So it's not like that. So they work. It's a very professional film industry. Ye koi uncle auntie ya koi relationship se nahi chalta hai ye udhar. So it's work.
Very relationship to chalta hai.
Relationship ka nahi bol raha. Main suppose we are very good friend, but she may not be, you know, it's not like that I'm going to get a chance to work with her film. So she has their own people. She believes in her work or and she has her own team. So she is going to work and she's depending on him or her about sound design or camera or something like that. Abhi, suppose if somebody is going from Assam, he's a cinematographer, even though he is passed out from LA Film School or Pune Film School or any Hi-Fi Film School, New York Film School, if he is Assamese, some Soikya Bora Gohai, and you know, going to meet Reema, Kagti and say, "Kisi, I am Assam, I am from LA Film School, please give me a chance to work in your film." Nahi hoga. It's not going to happen in that way. Okay.
Yeah, you say it's you don't know how to speak well. You don't know how to speak.
Am I right or wrong? So whoever it is, he may be Bora, Saikya, Dutta, whoever it is, LF Film School, FTF Film School, some other film school, he or she has to prove that, see, these are my films. I already made or worked as a cinematographer or sound designer or editor. These are my 10 films. And he can come with those films and show it to her. If she get impressed with the quality and work, then he need to beg for work. She will say, come, work for my next film. I think things like that.
That's what I wanted to add. I think in the last 10-15 years, there's been a lot of people from Assam and the Northeast coming out and working in the film industry in Bombay, and a lot of them are very good. And I often work with crew from the Northeast. I just want to clarify that it's not like I never work. But like he's saying, is, you know, to me, the fact that they're from the Northeast is secondary to the talent and the skill that they bring to the table. So, and there are a lot of people like that. And I feel proud to see so many Northeasterners come out and function in Bombay.
The way you speak, you say you don't know how to speak. But the way you speak reminds me of another great Assamese who's always, you know, asking the nation for answers because the nation wants to know just how you are speaking. Yeah, you are a great orator.
Well,
I would say way more charming.
Can I make my point?
And good looking also.
And he's letting the rest of us speak a little bit also.
Can I make my point?
Yes, sir.
Oh, my name is Manas Ranjan Mahapatra. I'm from Odisha. And right now I'm at Shillong with Northeastern Council. I'm very happy that Ritesh made some reference about representation of Odisha. I thought it's not exactly a question, but I thought it is proper to inform about the Odia films. Like Hollywood, Bollywood, we have also coined a word. We coined it 35 years back when I was in a news desk. It is Ollywood. We call it Ollywood. But Ollywood those days was Cuttack. Now Ollywood is Bhubaneswar, not Cuttack. So the city has come to the capital city of the state. Well, the representation you spoke of, I'll just tell you, there have been some very interesting, very talented actors like Sadhu Meher. You may have heard about Sadhu Meher. Very talented directors like Shishir Mishra and Sushant Mishra, whose first film was made to Cannes. But they are very fussy about the benchmark. They are very, Sushant makes a film in 10 years or so. So like that, even Sadhu Meher, he was in Mumbai, he made some very good films, but then he stopped, he came to Odisha. People also, like you are talking of Northeast, our people also speak of Odisha, and most of the things are around Lord Jagannath. So then something to be done. About the cities also, in my school, college and young days, I used to find only Cuttack. If at best Bhubaneswar, something Mahanadi. Mahanadi has to be in the films. Now it is going through a lot of changes. Manmohan Mahapatra, I forgot to mention, Nirad Mahapatra, whose film was made to Berlin and many places. They are there, but they are very fussy. They are now, their benchmark is so high. They have set a benchmark for themselves that we will not do this unless this is done. X, Y, Z, whatever. But as such, Amrit. Amrit has eased one thing. Bollywood is a very competitive market. Every market is a very competitive market. Is there necessity to have a regional identity? Whether this is a producer or director or hero, it has to be. It has to be on a general assumption that your role has to be very good, has to be superb. Whether you are a writer, you are a director, whatever. Probably, I have this, I also, Amrit has of course said, is there any requirement? Can't we discard it that X is to be there? If it is on Odisha, Jagannath is to be there. If it is on Northeast, suppose Northeastern India, Brahmaputra has to be there, or Siang has to be there, or a person should look like somebody from the Northeast, Northeastern India. Many people, I also confuse. These days, coming to Shillong, that confusion has gradually it is coming to an end. Many Mijo people, I confuse that they are from Japan. And that happens many parts of the country. People confuse because they are used to seeing Japanese and not Mizo people. It's also, so is it required? Is it, can't a film be only generalized? No such regional thing should be there. Should we be very fussy about the names and titles?
Then we'll be shooting the entire movie on CGI graphics with a blue thing at the back.
That depends. Yeah.
That'll be great. You want to very quickly
because you run out of time. No, it's not necessary, and in fact, it doesn't make business sense also. But since we are not charging off the business side, the corporate side, for an industry which has a success ratio of 10%, in spite of keeping all the parameters in mind, they should actually experiment a lot more, and they'll make a lot more money experimenting. They should have a Danny as a hero. I agree that they should take a SME's hero. Maybe he'll be the next big thing because they have a very poor success ratio anyway. The second question, should it be generic? It can't be. 9 out of 10 stories have to be localized somewhere. Because they are local, they become universal. A history, geography, region, accent, age, sex, it's very, very important. We can't get generalized in art. Art has to come up with attitudes, POVs, and eventually we'll have to, samay ka paya aage, we have to move forward. We can't get stuck, even from a business point of view. We should really expand.
Right, with that, we come to the end of our discussion. I would like to thank my panelists. It's great. You know, it's been quite an experience. Everything that you've said, I'm going to take it back. I'm going to keep it in my heart. And maybe one day, inspire many. I guess what they do as the heart of the Hindi film industry and coming here, making an effort to come here, is to give us two things. One is hope, and second is inspiration. So like them, we can inspire. And these are two things that money can never, ever buy. Thank you.